الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وسلم تسليما. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كانت لهم جنات الفردوس نزلا. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: إن الله اشترى من المؤمنين أنفسهم وأموالهم بأن لهم الجنة. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: ولمن خاف مقام ربه جنتان. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: تلك الجنة التي نورث من عبادنا من كان تقيا. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: قال الله تعالى: أعددت لعباد الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. واقرأوا إن شئتم فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين. رواه الإمامان الإمام المسلم والبخاري في صحيحهما، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. My respected brothers, elders, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran al-Kareem, إن الذين آمنوا, those who believe, وعملوا الصالحات, and thereafter do good deeds, كانت لهم جنات الفردوس نزلا. They shall receive جنة الفردوس for their entertainment. Allah says, إن الله اشترى من المؤمنين أنفسهم وأموالهم بأن لهم الجنة. He has purchased from the believers their lives and their wealth and property. And what is he going to give them in return? Allah is going to give them Jannah in return. Yet again Allah says in Surah Ar-Rahman, وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ. As for that believer who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and performs all the duties ordained by Allah and His Messenger Muhammad Arabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and refrains from evil and sin, for him there are two gardens in paradise. Yet again Allah says in Surah An-Nazi'at, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. As for him who feared standing in front of his Lord, and he restrained himself from impure evil desire, فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى, verily Jannah will be his abode. Yet again the Quran says, تلك الجنة التي نورث من عبادنا من كان تقيا. Such is the Jannah that we will give as inheritance to those of our people who were muttaqeen, who were God-fearing, who were righteous, and who were pious. The Quran is full with verses like this, in which Allah promised those who believe and do good deeds that they will inherit Jannah, that they will receive Jannah. Open the books of Ahadith and you will see that the books of Ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are full with Ahadith which promise those believers who do good deeds that they will inherit Jannah, that they will receive Jannah. This is why we see time after time the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encourages believers to do good deeds, and thereafter the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam promises the believers that they will receive Jannah. مَنْ سَلَّ الْبَرْدَيْنِ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever reads the morning prayer and asr prayer, he will enter Jannah. أَفْشُ السَّلَامُ وَأَطْئِمُ السَّعَامُ وَصِلُوا الْأَرْحَامُ وَصَلُوا بِالْلَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامُ تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ بِالسَّلَامُ. O believers, spread salam and do these good deeds that have been mentioned in this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you will all enter Jannah. مَنْ يَضْمَنْ مَا بَيْنَ لِحْيَيْهِ وَمَا بَيْنَ فَخِذَيْهِ أَضْمَنْ لَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever gives me guarantee of that thing that is between his two cheeks and that thing that is between his thighs, then I, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give him guarantee that he will receive Jannah. The Quran and the books of Ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are full with Ahadith in which the believers, you and I, and those who after believing in Allah and his messenger Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do good deeds, they will receive Jannah. But the question is, what is inside this Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And what is so special about the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that time after time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his book Al-Quran Al-Kareem, time after time Allah promises the believers that they will receive Jannah if they do good deeds. What will you and I, inshallah, receive in this Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What ni'mas will Allah give you and I, inshallah, in the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is the question that needs to be answered. However, I must mention that it is virtually impossible to answer this question as it should be answered. As Allah himself says, أَعْدَدْتُ لِعِبَادِ الصَّالِحِينَ مَا لَا أَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرْ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. Allah says that I have prepared for my good servants in Jannah that which no eye has seen, that which no ear has heard, and that which has not crossed the mind of any human being. So this is why I can only give you a rough guide to what is inside Jannah, as the true nature of the blessings of Jannah, the true nature of the pleasures of Jannah are inconceivable. What does this hadith say? No eye has ever seen them, no ear has ever heard them, and these things have never crossed the mind of any human being. This is what is inside the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me give you an example to understand this. A child, when he's inside his mother's womb, he cannot conceive of the things that are in this world. No matter how hard you explain, no matter how hard you describe, he can only see these things and understand these things once he has been born and he has entered the world and seen these things with his own eyes. Likewise, at this moment in time, you and I, we are in the womb. We are in the dunya. And it is impossible to conceive the true nature of the blessings and the ni'mas of Jannah while we remain in the womb, in the dunya. The hidden realities of Jannah and the true nature of the blessings of Jannah will come to perfect light, inshallah, once we enter Jannah and we see the ni'mas of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with our own eyes. So this is why I can only give you an example. I can only give you a rough guide. And I am going to try my best today, insha'Allah, to bring Jannah and the ni'mas of Jannah as close as I possibly can in the light of the Quran and the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is Allah going to give to believers in Jannah? Let us begin with the last person to come out from the fire of hell, the last person to enter Jannah. Let us see what Allah is going to give this last person to come out of the fire of hell and enter Jannah. Let us see what Allah is going to give him. Let us just see the ni'mah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give to this last person. However, to understand this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will have to understand. It is my belief, it is your belief, it is the belief of the Ahl Sunnah that a kafir will never enter Jannah. A kafir, in spite of the good deeds he may have done in this world, because he rejected Allah, because he denied Allah, and because he did not believe in Allah, he will never enter Jannah. He will be thrown into the fire of hell, and he will remain there forever and ever, punished and tortured by the fire of hell. As for the believers, as for the Muslims, that is you and I, we can divide the Muslims into two groups. Those that have never committed sin, those that are free from sin, like the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enter Jannah straight away. As for those believers who, as well as worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, committed many sins, they will be under the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, تحت المشيع. If Allah wishes to forgive them, then He is Ar-Rahman, then He is Ar-Rahim, He is the most merciful and He is the most kind, and He can do so. And if Allah wishes to punish them for the sins they committed in this world, then Allah can do so. But once these people have paid the price of their sins and served their time in the fire of hell, Allah the most merciful will take them out from the fire of hell and He will put them inside Jannah. The kuffar will never enter Jannah. The believers that never committed sin will enter Jannah straight away. And those that committed sin, they will be under the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah wishes to forgive them, then He can do so. And if Allah wishes to punish them, then He can do so. The difference is that one day the believers will enter Jannah. Let us now move on to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which describes what the last person to enter Jannah will receive, the ni'mas Allah will give him. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu reports that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, آخر من يدخل الجنة رجل فهو يمشي مرة ويكبو مرة وتصفعه النار مرة فإذا ما جاوزها التفت إليها فقال تبارك الذي نجاني منك لقد أعطاني الله شيئا ما أعطاه أحدا من الأولين والآخرين. عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه سيد that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the last person to come out from the fire of hell and thus the last person to enter Jannah will be a man who will crawl out of the fire of hell and he will enter Jannah. Try to picture this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in your mind's eye. Remember and do not forget that this is the last person, the last to come out from the fire of hell, and he is the last to enter Jannah. He has been in the fire of hell for a very long time, maybe thousands of years. Allah knows best. Serving his time and paying the price of his sin, punished and tortured, tormented and roasted by the fire of hell. The time has now come for him to be released. He has served his time, and Allah the Almighty is letting him out from the fire of hell, and Allah is letting him inside Jannah. My brothers, he will muster courage to come out from the fire of hell. He will begin to crawl, and he will crawl for a few yards, and he will make the effort to stand and walk. He will stand and he will begin to walk, though faltering. He's leaving the fire of hell. The fire of hell scorches him. He stumbles and he falls. Yet again, he begins to crawl on his belly, and he crawls for a few yards. Yet again, he makes the effort to stand and walk, and he begins to walk, and he walks for a few yards. He's leading the fire of hell. The fire of hell burns him. He stumbles and he falls. For there is no turning back today, because the gates of hell are open. Allah the Almighty is letting him out from the fire of hell. He can see freedom. He can smell freedom. He is thinking freedom. There is no turning back today. فَوَيَمْشِي مَرَّةً وَيَكْبُو مَرَّةً وَتُصْفِئُهُ النَّارُ مَرَّةً. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, this is how he will leave the fire of hell. He will crawl for a few yards. He will walk for a few yards. He will stumble and he will walk. And he will walk and he will not give up. Yet again he will begin to crawl. Yet again he will begin to walk. And finally he is out of the fire of hell. He has made it. He is now out of the fire of hell. And he cannot believe his eyes that he has made it out of the fire of hell. He will be thinking in his mind that Allah has never released anybody from the fire of hell. He will be thinking that he is the one in the billion that Allah has taken out from the fire of hell and let him into Jannah. And thus, he will turn to the fire of hell, and he will glorify Allah, and he will praise Allah, and he will say, تبارك الذي نجاني منك. Glorified is the one, all praise to the one who saved me from you, who rescued me from you. He is talking to the fire of hell. لَكَدْ أَعْطَانِي اللَّهُ شَيْئًا مَا أَعْطَاهُ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخِرِينَ. Today Allah has given me such a ni'mah. Allah has given me such a thing that Allah has never ever given to anybody before me, nor the أَوَّلِينَ and nor the آخِرِينَ, nor the former and nor the latter. He has made it and he's out from the fire of hell. فترفع له شجر. A tree will be brought in front of him. A beautiful tree with a beautiful shade and sweet water flowing beneath it. He's been in the fire of hell for a very long time. He's probably still feeling the after effects of it. He's probably still hot. In the fire of hell, he was given blood to drink. He was given pus to drink. He was given boiling water to drink, which wrecked his inside. And now, he can see a tree. A beautiful tree with a beautiful shade and water flowing beneath it. It is at a distance. He's already barely managed to crawl out of the fire of hell. With difficulty, he crawled out of the fire of hell. He fell many times, and finally, He made it out of the fire of hell. He's thirsty. He's never rested before because he was in the fire of hell, tortured and punished. He's never drunk sweet water before because he was given boiling water in the fire of hell, which wrecks his inside. And now he can see a tree and he can see this water flowing beneath it. How does he get there? He will turn to Allah and he will say, أدنيني من هذه الشجرة. أي ربي أدنيني من هذه الشجرة فلأستظل بظلها وأشرب من مائها. Oh Allah, make me closer to this tree so I can shelter under its shade and so I can drink its sweet water. Allah will say, يبنى آدم لأني إن أعتيتكها سألتني غيرها. O Ibn Adam, it is possible that once I've given you what you've asked for and made you closer to this tree and you've rested under it and you've drunk in its sweet water, you will ask for something else. Ya Rabbi. He will say, Wallah, I am not going to ask for anything else. Wallah, just make me close to this tree. Let me shelter under its shade and drink from its sweet water. Wallah, I am not going to ask for anything else. وَيُؤَاهِدُهُ أَلَّا يَسْأَلُهُ غَيْرَهَا. And he will promise and he will vow and he will make qasam. Qasam to Allah, I am not going to ask for anything else. And he will make mu'ahada with Allah. وَرَبُّهُ تَعَالَى يَعْذِرُ لَأَنَّهُ يَرَى مَا لَا صَبْرَهُ عَلَيْهِ. Allah is the most merciful and the most kind. He begins the Quran with Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will regard him as ma'zoor. He will regard him as an invalid. As his servant has seen a ni'mah over which he cannot make sabr. Allah will make him closer to this tree. فَيَسْتَظِلُّ بِذِلِّهَا وَيَشْرَبْ مِنْ مَائِهَا. And he will shelter under its shade and he will rest for the first time. And he will drink its sweet water. ثُمَّ تُرْفَعْ لَهُ شَجَرَةٌ هِيَ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ الْأُولَى. He just rested. He's just drunk the sweet water. When all of a sudden, a tree more beautiful than the first will be brought in front of him. He just tasted the sweet water flowing beneath the first. Now this tree is no better than the first. And he can see it. He can see the water flowing beneath it. And he will forget the promise that he's made Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he will forget the qasam. And he will forget the mu'ahada. And yet again, he will turn to Allah because he knows Allah is Ar-Rahman. And he knows Allah is Ar-Rahim. And he will say to Allah, أي ربي أدنيني من هذه الشجرة فلأستظل بظلها وأشرب من مائها. والله, make me closer to this second tree. This second is more beautiful than the first. والله, make me close to it so I can shelter under its shade and I can drink from its sweet water. Allah will say, يا ابن آدم ألم تؤاهدني ألا تسألني غيرها. Oh ابن آدم, didn't you promise me? Did you make mu'ahad and qasam that you were not going to ask for anything else? And you've already started. You're asking for me to put you closer to the second tree. It is possible that once I've put you closer to the second tree and you've enjoyed yourself underneath it, you've rested, you've drunk from its sweet water, you'll come round again and you'll ask for something else. He will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, I am not going to ask for anything else. And yet again for the second time, he will promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيُؤَاهِدُهُ أَلَّا يَسْأَلُهُ غَيْرَهَا. And he will vow to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاللَّهُ just this one, I am not going to ask for anything else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful and the most kind. وَرَبَّهُ تَعَالَى يَعْذِرُ لَأَنَّهُ يَرَى مَا لَا صَبْرُهُ عَلَيْهِ. Allah will regard him as an invalid. He will regard him as ma'zur. And Allah, for the second time, will make him close to the second tree. As his servant has seen a ni'mah over which he cannot make sabr. And he will shelter under its shade. And he will drink from its sweet water. He's just drunk the sweet water flowing beneath the second tree. ثم ترفع له شجرة عند باب الجنة هي أحسن من الأوليين. My brothers, he's just rested and drunk the sweet water flowing beneath the second tree, when all of a sudden, to me it seems like as if Allah is teasing him. Allah must say, a third tree will be brought in front of him, and this third tree is right next to the gates of Jannah, and this third tree will put the first and second to shame. It is more beautiful than the first two trees, and he can see it with his eyes, and he can see the sweet water flowing beneath it. Yet again he will forget the promises he made Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and yet again he will turn to Allah and he will ask, أدنيني من هذه الشجرة فلأستظل بظلها وأشرب من مائها. Oh Allah, make me closer to this third tree. Oh Allah, it is better than the first. Oh Allah, it is better than the second. Oh Allah, make me close to this third tree so I can shelter under its shade and I can drink from its sweet water. Allah will yet again say to him, Ibn Adam, ألم تواهدني ألا تسألني غيرها. Oh Ibn Adam, you broke from promise. Now the second one you've already broke. Can you promise that you were not going to ask for anything else, and yet again you've started again? My brothers and sisters, my brothers, he will say to Allah, هذه لا أسألك غيرها. He will begin to beg like a child. When a child desperately needs something from a father, it begins to beg, and it begins to use words like pretty please, just this one. Oba, just this one. I will be a good boy. Just give me this thing. Just the last time. And he will beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hazihi, O Allah, just this once. I am not going to ask for anything else. O Allah, just make me close to this third tree. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful and the most kind, will make him close to this third tree, which is more beautiful than the first and the second. فَإِذَا أَدْنَاهُ مِنْهَا فَيَسْمَعُ أَسْوَاتَ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. He is so close to Jannah that when Allah makes him close to this third tree, he will be able to hear the sweet voices of the people of Jannah. He will be able to hear the people of Jannah rejoicing, the people of Jannah talking amongst themselves. He will be able to hear the Hur'een singing. My brothers, would you blame him? He will say to Allah, Udkhulniha, O Allah, let me go inside Jannah. He has come from a long way. He has come from the depths of the fire of hell. My brothers and sisters, he found it very difficult to come out from the fire of hell. He crawled out of the fire of hell. He walked out of the fire of hell, and the fire of hell caught him as he was leaving. It burned him as he was leaving. He was finally out. My brothers, Allah brings a tree in front of him, and this tree is absolutely beautiful. It has water beneath it. He has never drank water. He has never rested under a tree. Then Allah brings him to closer to a second tree, and then Allah brings him close to a third tree, and this tree is so close to Jannah that he can hear the people of Jannah talk him amongst themselves. He can hear the sweet voices of the Hur'een, and he will not be able to bear it. He will not be able to take it, and he will be forced to say, Oh Allah, udkhulniha, Oh Allah, let me go inside your Jannah. Oh Allah, let me go inside your Jannah. I have come from so far, and I am so close. Let me inside. Allah will say, Ibn Adam, ما يسريني منك أيرضيك أن أعطيك الدنيا ومثلها معها. Oh Ibn Adam, when are all these cons going to come to an end? All these promises, I'm breaking these promises, when are they all going to come to an end? When are all these demands that you make, make me close to this tree, make me close to that tree, When is it all going to come to an end? When is it all going to stop? أيرضيك أن أعطيك الدنيا ومثلها معها؟ Oh, Ibn Adam, would you be happy if I gave you a place in Jannah which was twice as big as the world you came from? In this narration, it is mentioned twice as big. In another narration, it is mentioned 10 times as big. My brothers, he will say to Allah, Ya Rabbi, أتستهزئ مني وأنت رب العالمين؟ Oh Allah, you are playing about with me? Oh Allah, you are casting jokes of me? You are making fun of me? You are going to give me, though you are the Lord of the universe, though you are Allah, the creator of the universe, you are playing jokes with the last person to come out of the fire of hell, the last to enter Jannah. You are going to give this servant of yours a place in Jannah, which is 2 times, and in one narration, 10 times bigger than the world that I came from? فضحك ابن مسعود. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, who is narrating this hadith, began to laugh and smile. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud asked those that were sitting in front of him, to whom he was narrating this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَلَا تَسْأَلُونِ مِمَّا أَضْحَكُ. Do you not ask me why I am laughing and smiling? Do you not ask me what has made me laugh and smile? Those that were listening to this hadith, they asked Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Oh Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, مِمَّا أَضْحَكُ. Tell us what makes you laugh. Why you smile, oh Abdullah ibn Mas'ud? Share it with us. Listen very carefully. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu says, حَكَذَا ضَحِكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. When the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was narrating this hadith to us companions, when the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reached this point, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam began to laugh and smile. And we, the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, asked the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, what has made you laugh? Ya Rasulullah, why do you smile? And the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Min zihki rabbil alameen. But I smile because Allah began to laugh. Allah began to smile when his servant is saying to him, أتستهزئ مني وأنت رب العالمين. A servant, the last to come out of the fire of hell. And he's saying to Allah, Oh Allah, are you joking? Are you joking? Are you playing with me? Are you making fun of me? Allah began to laugh. Look at Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala an. Look at the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala an majma'in. And then we ask why they received the certificate of Jannah while they were alive. Radiyallahu anhu wa radu an. He has observed the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam laughing when the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrated this hadith. He acts upon it himself and he conveys it to others. And it is because of this the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een received Jannah, because they followed the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and thereafter passed it to everybody else. Allah will say to this person, لَأَسْتَهْزِئُ مِنْكَ وَلَكِنِّي أَلَى مَا أَشَاهُ قَادِرٌ. I'm not playing about with you. Nor am I joking. I am Allah. I am Lord of the universe, the most powerful. And I can do what I please. And I am going to give you a place in Jannah, which is twice, and in one narration, 10 times. Bigger than the world you came from. In the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala an, regarding the same last person to enter Jannah, in the latter part of this hadith it is mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, Taman, wish, ask for what you like. He will ask and Allah will provide. Allah yet again will say, Tamanna, ask for what you like, wish. He will wish and he will ask and Allah will provide. And Allah will keep on providing. He will keep on asking and Allah will keep on providing. When he has asked for everything that he can think of, وَيُذَكِّرَهُ اللَّهُ سَلْكَذَا وَكَذَا. Allah will begin to remind him of the things that he has forgotten to ask. Allah will say, ask for this. This person will ask for it. Allah will give. Allah, for example, will say, you forgot to ask for a BMW 7 Series. Now is your chance. He will ask for it. Allah will provide. Oh, my servant, you forgot to ask for a Merc convertible. This is your chance. Ask for it. He will ask for it and he will be given. When all his desires are fulfilled, فإذا انقطع به الأمان فهو لك وأشرة أمثالي. Who take it all and you can have 10 times as much. Who is this person? The last to come out from the fire of hell and the last to enter Jannah. Not you and I, as you and I inshallah will not be from amongst the last to enter Jannah inshallah. We'll be from amongst the first. Insha'Allah, and this is the last person to enter Jannah, and it is not all over yet. Now that he's received a respectable place in Jannah, 10 times bigger than this world, he will say to Allah, Al-Haqni bin Nas. Oh Allah, let me go meet with the people. He will be keen and eager to meet the rest of the people. Maybe now that he's a king in his own kingdom, maybe he wants to show the boys that he's the man now. A place in Jannah, 10 times bigger than the world. Maybe he wants to show the boys that he's the man now. Or maybe he's feeling lonely. Long time since he's met any friends, been in the fire of hell. Allah knows. He will turn around and he will say to Allah, Allah al-hikmi bin nas. Allah, let me go meet the people. Allah will say, ilhaq bin nas, go, go. Go meet the people. فَيَنْطَلِقُ فَيَرْمُلُ فِي الْجَنَّةِ حَتَّى إِذَا دَنَا مِنَ النَّاسِ وَرُفِعَ لَهُ قَصْرٌ مِّن دُرَّةٍ فَيَخِرُّ سَاجِدًا. Now he's in Jannah. He will begin to roam and he will begin to run around in Jannah. When he is pretty close to the people, when he is pretty close to the people, a palace made out of a huge pearl will be brought in front of him. And this palace will be so beautiful, it will have so much light coming from it, so much noor, that he will fall into sajda. He will think it is Allah. He will think this light, a nur, is a nur of Allah. It is the light of Allah. And he will fall into prostration. He will fall into sajda. فَيُخِرُّ سَاجِدًا. It will be said to him, اِرْفَعْ رَاسِكَ مَالِكَ. Hold on brother, what are you doing? What are you bowing down for in Jannah? What's the matter? Lift your head. He will reply, رَأَيْتُ رَبِّي. I saw Allah, I saw the nur of Allah. Would you blame him, brother? The last to come out of the fire of hell. He's never seen anything so beautiful, and there is so much nur, so much light coming from this palace, that he thinks that he's seen Allah. We said to him, إِنَّمَا هُوَ مَنْزِلٌ مِّن مَنَازِلِ. That wasn't Allah. That's just one of the many palaces that you have inherited, that you have received. He walks a few yards. ثم يلقى رجل فيتهيأ للسجود له. He sees a beautiful, handsome young man. He has never seen anybody so handsome like this before. And he will be on the verge of jumping down and going for sajda again. Ma, hold on. What are you doing? He will reply, رَحَيْتُ أَنَّكَ مَلَكٌ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَ. He's never seen somebody so handsome, and he will think, he will say to him, that I thought that you were one of the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers, he will reply, إِنَّمَا أَنَا خَازِنٌ مِّنْ خُزَّانِكَ وَعَبْدٌ مِّنْ عَبِيدِكَ تَحْتَ يَدَيَّ أَلْفُ قَحْرَمَانِ. I am not the angel. I'm not one of the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm just a clerk. I'm just one of your servants. There are 1,000 that work under me, and they're all yours. I'm just one of your slaves. فينطلق أمامه حتى يحت له القصر. And he will walk in front of him. And he will open the door to his palace. وهو من ذرة مجوفة سقائفها وأبوابها وأغلاقها ومفاتيحها منها. The palace will be made from a huge hollow pearl. Its doors, its keys, its rooms, its roof, all from the same thing. And facing this will be a huge green jewel concealed in a red one. فيها 70 باب كل باب يفضي إلى جوهرة خضراء مبطنة. It will have 70 doors, and each door will lead to a room made out of a green gem. في كل جوهرة سرر وأزواج ووصايا. And every room there will be couches, and his wife will be sitting on these couches, and there will be maids. The least of these women will be so beautiful, كأدناهن حوراء حوراء عينا عليها 70 حلة يرى مخ ساقيا من وراء حللها. But she will have wide, lovely eyes, 70 pairs of dress, and the whiteness of her skin will be visible from all these pairs of dress. إذا أعرض عنها إعراضة ازدادت في عينه 70 ذئبا. When he turns his face from her, she becomes 70 times more beautiful than she was in his eyes. And it will be said to him, have a look at your kingdom. Have a quick glance at your kingdom. فيشرف. And he will have a quick glance at his kingdom. ملكك مسيرة 100 عام. It will be said, the distance that can be covered in 100 years, in one narration, 1,000 years, the distance that can be covered in this time, that is where your kingdom ends. And this is the last person to enter Jannah. And this is not all. As in the hadith of Ibn Umar, which can be found in Dari Qutni, حتى إذا انتهى إلى صرير ملك اتكى عليه. When this last person to enter Jannah reaches his throne in his kingdom, he will sit on it like a king. فيسعى عليه بسبعين سحفة ليس فيها سحفة من لون أختها. 70 trays of gold will be brought in front of him, all containing a special dish, a special type of food which he has never eaten before. يجد لذة آخرها كما يجد لذة أولها. And he will taste and enjoy the last dish as he tasted and enjoyed the first. He is sitting on his throne and is now eating. ثم يسعى إليه بألوان الأشربة. Different types of drink will be brought in front of him. فيشرب ما يستحق. And he will drink what he pleases. Now that he's drunk and eaten, the steward will say, اتركوا وأزواجه. Let him be with his wife now. Give him some privacy. All the servants will go away. فإذا حوراء من الحور العين جالسة, she will reply in a sweet voice, كأنا من الحور العين من اللاتي خبئن لك. I am only one from amongst the many حور العين which have been specially saved for you. she will be so beautiful. ينظر إليها 40 سنة لا يصرف بصره عنها. That he will look at her for 40 years. For 40 years he will admire her beauty and he will not take his eyes off her. His eyes will be pierced on her. His eyes will be fixed on her. He will not even blink for 40 years. Now I bet you're thinking, how beautiful can she be? Come on, 40 years? He's going to look at her for 40 years? Then let me tell you that the Huri'een of Allah are a special creation. They don't like the women of this world. Chit-chat, trouble, problem. No. A special creation. And they are remarkably beautiful. Her fingertip is so beautiful. لو أن بعض بنانها بدا لغلب ضوءه ضوء الشمس والقمر. That if her fingertip was to become visible, it is so beautiful, it is so white that the light and gleam of that one fingertip would prevail the sunlight and the moonlight. The sunlight and the moonlight would be nothing in comparison. Its light would put the sunlight and the moonlight to shame. Her hair smells so beautiful. كَلَوْ أَنَّ طَاقَةً مِنْ شَعْرِهَا بَدَتْ لَمَلَعَتْ مَا بَيْنِ الْمَشْرِكِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ مِنْ طِيبِ رِيحِهَا. But if some of her hair were to appear, then whole of the world, from the east to west, would be filled with the perfume, with a sweet fragrance. Her saliva is so sweet. كَلَوْ أَنَّ حَوْرَاهُ بَصَقَ فِي سَبْعَةِ أَبْحُرٍ لَعُذِبَتِ الْبِحَارِ مِنْ عَزُوبَةِ فَمِحَ. That if she was to spit just once in the seven oceans, then the salty water of the seven oceans would become sweeter than sugar due to the sweetness of her mouth and the sweetness of her saliva. When she makes us be in Jannah, لم يبقى شجرة في الجنة إلا وردت. Her sweet voice is such that because of her tasbih, all the trees in Jannah begin to shake. When she smiles at a husband, سطأ نور في الجنة فرفعوا أبصارهم. A noor comes out of her mouth and it rises and it spreads into Jannah. This is how beautiful the Huri'een are. Her fingertip would put the sun and moon to shame. Her saliva would put the sugar to shame. The smell of her hair would fill the whole earth with the perfume. And when she smiles, a noor comes out of her mouth, which all the people of Jannah see. And that is not all. Let me take you a step further. Let me share the question Hazrat Umm Salma radiallahu ta'ala anha asked the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding the Huri'een. And let me share these answers the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave to Umm Salma radiallahu ta'ala anha. Umm Salma radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, Ya Rasulullah, أخبرني عن قول الله عز وجل Huri'een. O Messenger of Allah, O Prophet of Allah, Allah says regarding the women of Jannah in the Quran, Huri'een. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell me what Huri'een means. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Hurun, Bidun, Inun, Dikham. That the women of Jannah will have big, white, beautiful, lustrous eyes. Ya Rasulullah, أخبرني عن قول الله عز وجل كأنهن الياقوت والمرجان. O Messenger of Allah, Allah says in the Quran al-Kareem that the women of Jannah are like if they, as if they were the ruby and the coral stone. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell me what this means. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Safa'uhunna ka safa'i dur. Safa'uhunna ka safa'i dur alladhi fi al-asdaf alladhi la tamassuhu al-aydi. It means that in beauty and in purity they are as pure as that ruby which is in the depths of the ocean, hidden away in its oyster, which no human has ever touched. This is how beautiful and pure the Hurin are. She says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أخبرني عن قول الله عز وجل فيهن خيرات حسان. Allah says in the Quran al-Kareem regarding the women of Jannah that they are good and beautiful. Ya Rasulullah, what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referring to? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, خيرات الأخلاق وحسان الوجوه. Allah is referring to that they are good of nature, that they have good morals, they have good manners, they are good of character, and they are beautiful of face. They have a beautiful, charmful, lustrous beauty. She says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أخبرني عن قول الله عز وجل كأنهن بيض مكنون. Allah says in the Quran al-Kareem that the women of Jannah are as if they were delicate eggs, closely guarded. Ya Rasulullah, what does this mean? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, رقتهن كرقة الجلد الذي في داخل البيضة يلي القشر. It means that in softness, in gentleness, in delicateness, they are as delicate as the thin pea layer of skin which is inside the egg next to the shell. She says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أخبرني عن قول الله عز وجل أربا عتراب. Allah says in the Quran al-Kareem regarding the women of Jannah that they are loving and that they are the same age. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is Allah referring to? Who are those? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, هن اللواتي قبضن في دار الدنيا عجائز رمسا شمتا فخلقهن الله بعد الكبر. They are those that died in this world old and weak with white hair. Allah will create them again in Jannah, and He will beautify them, and He will make them pure and touched and untouched, and they will be full of love for their companions, and they are the ones that will be all the same age. They will be equal in age. Now Umm Salma radiallahu ta'ala an, when she hears this praise from the best of creation, from the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding the women of Jannah, she's a woman after all. She asks, أنساء الدنيا أفضل من الحور أم أنساء الدنيا أفضل أم حور أم أم الحور الإين. يا رسول الله, you have said so much about the حور الإين. يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, tell me who will be more superior in Jannah, who will be more beautiful and more أفضل in Jannah, will the women of this world be more أفضل in Jannah, or will the حور الإين be more أفضل in Jannah? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, نساء الدنيا أفضل من الحور الإين كفضل الزحارة على البتانة. O Umm Salma, do not worry, as the women of this world will be more superior and more beautiful than the حور الإين, like the upper quilt, like the upper cloth of a quilt is better than the undercloth of it. Now that she received her answer that she was looking for, say the number one, she asked the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَبِمَا ذَاكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, tell me why will the women of this world be better and more superior than the women of the next world. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, بِسَلَاتِهِنَّ وَصِيَامِهِنَّ وَعِبَادَتِهِنَّ اللَّهِ أَلْبَسَ اللَّهُ وَجُوهَهُنَّ النُّورِ وَأَسَادَهُنَّ الْحَرِيرِ. It is because they worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They offered prayers for Allah. They fasted for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is because of this, they will be more superior than the women of the next world. And Allah will put nur on their faces. He will put silk on their body. Their faces will be beautiful and white. And their bodies will be covered with jewels. This is why when the Huri'een sing for their husbands, when the Huri'een sing for their husbands, كَنَحْنُ الْخَالِدَاتِ فَلَا نَبِيدْ وَنَحْنُ النَّائِمَاتِ فَلَا نَبْعَثْ وَنَحْنُ الرَّاضِيَاتِ فَلَا نَفْخُثْ طُوبَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَنَا وَكُنَّ لَهُ. They will sing كَنَحْنُ الْخَالِدَاتِ فَلَا نَبِيدْ, that we are immortal, we will never perish. وَنَحْنُ النَّائِمَاتِ فَلَا نَبْعَثْ, we will always remain in peace and comfort, we will never turn needy. وَنَحْنُ الرَّاضِيَاتِ فَلَا نَفْخُثْ, that we will always be happy and never be angry with our husbands. What to say of those that are for us and we are for them? The women of this world will reply, نَحْنُ الْمُصَلِّيَاتُ وَمَا صَلَّيْتُنَّ وَنَحْنُ الصَّائِمَاتُ وَمَا صُمْتُنَّ وَنَحْنُ الْمُتَوَضِّئَاتُ وَمَا تَوَضَّأْتُنَّ وَنَحْنُ الْمُتَصَدِّقَاتُ وَمَا تَصَدَّقْتُنَّ. نحن المصليات, we were the ones who prayed in dunya, وما صمتنا وما صليتنا, not you little sister. ونحن المتوضئات وما توضأتنا, we were the ones who performed wuzu in dunya, not you little sister. We were the ones who gave sadaqah, we were the ones that worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All due respect to yourself, but it was we, the ones that did all this. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, فغلبنا, that the women of this world will overpower the Huri'een. The last question she asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was, she said, Ya Rasulullah, sometimes a woman gets married to more than one guy. Two, three, four. Either because her husbands have kept on dying, or either because she keeps on getting divorced. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell me, if she, when she dies and if she enters Jannah, and all of the husbands that she was married to, if they all enter Jannah, مَنْ يَكُونُ زَوْجُهَا مِنْهُمْ, who will be her husband in Jannah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Ya Ummi Salma, إِنَّهَا تُخَيَّ, she will be given a choice, and she can choose who she please. فَتَخْتَارُ أَحْسَنَهُمْ خُلَكًا, and she will choose the one that had the best character. Ummi Salma, she will say to Allah, أي ربي إن هذا كان أحسنهم معي خلقا فزوجني. Oh Allah, he was the best in character with me. Allah, let me marry him. And it is that one she will marry. So now can you blame him? He will look at her for 40 years. As these are the Huri'een. And this is how beautiful the Huri'een are, that his eyes will be fixed on her, and he will admire her beauty, and he will not blink for 40 years. After 40 years, he will take his eyes off her, and he will look into the room, in one of the rooms. فَإِذَنْ أُخْرَى أَجْمَلُ مِنْهَا, guess what? There is another one, and she is more beautiful than the first. And he will keep on looking at her for 40 years, yet again, he will not blink. Who is this guy? Who is this guy? The last to come out from the fire of hell, and the last to enter Jannah. And these are just some of the ni'mas that he will receive in Jannah. And on top of this, he will see Allah every morning and every evening. My brothers, if this is the last to enter Jannah, the last to come out of the fire of hell,
what are you and I, inshallah, going to receive in Jannah? As I've already mentioned, we are not going to be from amongst the last, inshallah. We will be from amongst the first. فَكِيفَ بِعَعْلَاهُمْ. What do you think those believers who are higher than him in rank, what are they going to receive? And what do you think the one with the highest rank in Jannah, Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is going to receive in Jannah? Let me take you for a quick walk in Jannah. Now that we know what the last person to enter Jannah is going to receive, let me just take you for a quick walk into Jannah and try to picture this walk the best you can in your mind's eye. Allah has just judged, and all those that are sitting here have received their records in their right hands, inshaAllah. And Allah has decided that all those that are sitting here today will be given Jannah, inshaAllah. The angels have come to take us to Jannah. We've reached Jannah. What will we see? What will we find? We will see that the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is absolutely massive. Just like Allah said in the Quran, أَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ, that its breadth will be like the breadth of all the heaven and the earth. And we will see that the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beautiful, just like the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described it, made out of gold and made out of silver. When the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een asked the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ma bina'uha, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made out of? The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, labinatun min zahab وَلَبِنَةٌ مِّنْ فِضَّةٍ وَمَلَاتُهَا الْمِسْكُ الْأَصْفَرُ وَهَسَاؤُهَا اللُّؤْلُؤُ وَالْيَاقُوتُ وَتُرْبَتُهَا زَعْفَرَانُ. So the Jannah of Allah is made out of brick of gold and a brick of silver. A brick of gold is placed, then a brick of silver is placed. Yet again a brick of gold, and yet again a brick of silver, and so forth. And these bricks of gold and silver not joined together with gravel, sand and cement. Oh no! These bricks of gold and silver are joined together with a special mixture. A mixture made out of musk, pearls and rubies to match the bricks of gold and silver. This is what we will see. It will have many doors. باب الصلاة, باب الصدقة, باب الريان, باب الجهاد, باب الذكر, the gate of jihad, the gate of zikr, the gate of salah, the gate of siyam, and so forth. And all these gates will be already open, and the wardens will be waiting to greet you and I, inshallah, as we arrive. Just like the Quran says, حتى إذا جاءوها فتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين. When they reach the gates of Jannah, the gates will be already open, and the wardens will say to them, سلام عليكم, you were the good ones, enter the gardens of paradise to dwell therein. Those who were steadfast on salah, on nafil salah, after their obligatory act, after their obligatory prayers, will enter from the gate of salah. He who was a man of jihad will enter from the gate of jihad. He who was a man of sadaqah, generously donated in the path of Allah, will enter from the gate of sadaqah. The gates will be named after good deeds, and we will all enter from the gate in accordance with the good deed that we were steadfast for. And those of us who was steadfast on many deeds. We were men of jihad, we were men of dhikr, we were men of sadaqah, we were men of siyam. They are the ones that will receive a special welcome. All the wardens on the different gates will all beg him to enter from that gate. The wardens of Babu Salat will say, "Oh Abid, please come through my gate." The wardens of Babu Jihad will say, "Oh Abid, no, please come through my gate." The wardens of Babu Rayyan will say, "Oh Abid, no, we beg you, enter from my gate." All the wardens from all the different gates will call him and they will beg him, though he is only going to enter from one gate. But this is the honor and special welcome he will receive. Now that we've entered Jannah from our respective gates, we will praise Allah. Alhamdulillah الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء. All praise to the one who has fulfilled his promise and made us inherit Jannah. We can live in Jannah where we please. Now we've entered Jannah, looking at ourselves, most of us are midgets. 5'8", 5'9", 5'10". Somebody 6'5". Wow, this guy is massive. We all remember. He's got a respectable height. He's a big guy. We look up to him. In Jannah, not 5'8", not 5'9", not even 6 foot. Allah will give us a respectable height. 60 cubic feet. As the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, فكل من يدخل الجنة على صورة آدم 60 ذراع. Whoever enters Jannah will look like, will be as tall as Adam alayhi salam, who was 60 cubic feet. Now that we've entered Jannah and Allah has given us a respectable height. And I bet those who shave, though you shouldn't be doing it as if it's a grievous sin, I bet it is a hard time. You've got to get to work at 9 o'clock. Maybe even the university. It's 8:55. You know? Your hair are itching. You yourself are thinking you're looking pretty ugly. Can't find the razor. Can't find the machine. 5 minutes left to get to work. I bet there's a lot of problems involved. And in Jannah, Allah has eradicated the problem. You won't need a razor. You won't need a machine. As nobody will have a beard. Nobody will have hair on the head. And nobody will have any hair on their body. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, يَدْخُلُ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ الْجَنَّةَ جُرْضًا مُرْضًا مُكَحَّلِينَ أَبْنَأَ ثَلَاثِينَ أو ثَلَاثَ ثَلَاثِينَ. Now the men of Jannah will be young, beardless, with chlorine colored eyes. 30 or 33. Now that we've entered respectable height, got rid of the hair problem, all we need now is a bit of beauty. We will be all beautified and made handsome according to our rank and status. إِنَّ أَوَّلَ زُمْرَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ عَلَى سُورَةِ الْقَمَرِ لَيْلَةَ الْضَوْءِ. The first group to enter Jannah, their faces will be so beautiful and so bright like the moon on the 14th night. ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ كأشد كوكب ذري في السماء إضاءة. And those that follow thereafter will be as beautiful and their faces will shine like the most illuminated, most shining star in the sky, and so forth. And this is the beauty once we've entered. The most of these kuffar women and now others are also following 2-3 times a week to the beauty parlor. How are we going to maintain this beauty? In Jannah, you don't need to maintain the beauty. As your beauty will increase, just go to the local marketplace and you will become more handsome. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, in Jannah there is a special marketplace which the people of Jannah will visit every Friday. فَتَحُبُّ رِيحُ الشِّمَالِ فَتَحْسُ فِي وَجُوئِهِمْ وثيابهم فيزدادون حسنا وجمالا. A northerly breeze will blow into their faces and in their clothes, and thereafter, automatically, they will become more beautiful and more handsome. And when they return to their families, in their absence, their families will also have become more beautiful and handsome. Now that we've got a respectable height, got rid of the hair, looking pretty good. All we need now are the clothes to match. Yeah? What's the latest design you wear in Jannah? What's the latest gay in Jannah? How about if we could all just dress like kings forever and ever? How about what the Quran says? وَيَلْبَسُونَ ثِيَابًا خُضْرًا مِنْ صُنْدُسٍ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٍ يُحَلَّوْنَ فِيهَا مِنْ أَسَاوِرٍ مِنْ ذَهَبٍ وَيَلْبَسُونَ ثِيَابًا خُضْرًا مِنْ صُنْدُسٍ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٍ Green robes of finest silk with gold embroidery and armlets of gold. How about a crown to match? Regarding which the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, okay, that the lowest diamond in this crown will have such a gleam and such a light that it would be able to brighten the whole world from the east to the west and everything within it. Now that we've put on our gear, all we need to do is let's just take a small walk. What will we see? There will be trees everywhere. Not a boring sycamore, pine, oak. No, the Quran says, فِيهِمَ فَاكِهَةٌ وَنَخْلٌ وَرُمَّانٌ Pomegranate trees, palm trees everywhere. إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازًا حَدَائِكَ وَعْنَابٌ Vineyards everywhere. فِي سِدْرٍ مَخْضُودٍ وَطَلْحٍ مَنْدُودٍ وَظِلٍ مَمْدُودٍ Fullness of trees, clustered plantations. And these trees will be so beautiful. كما في الجنة شجرة إلا وساقها من ذهب من فضة. That the trunks of these trees will be made of silver. And the branches will be all of different materials. And on these trees, ولهم فيها من كل الثمرات. Different types of fruit. And the beauty about this fruit is وَذُلِّلَتْ كُتُوفُهَا تَذْلِيلًا When you were small, you would climb the next door neighbor's apple tree. And now we've grown out of it. In Jannah, you won't need to climb the tree as the fruit will come to you. The branch will bow down to you. All you've got to do, put it inside, eat it. There will be rivers flowing everywhere. فيها أنهار من ماء غير آسِن وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه وأنهار من خمر لذة للشاربين وأنهار من عسل مصفى Rivers of water, fresh water, which is not polluted like the rivers of England. Rivers of milk whereof the flavor has not changed. And rivers of wine flowing, which is delicious for the drink. And rivers of pure, clear honey. Dive in. Drink as much as you please. It is all there for you, inshallah. Now that we've taken a walk, we feel a bit peckish. How about something to eat? Guess what? There's a bird flying in Jannah. And it reminds us of a batera. A lot of the Pakistani brothers like the batera, quail. It reminds us of a batera in dunya. And you're thinking, if only if I could, guess what? فيخر بين يديك مشوية. Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, desire and the bird will fall in front of you already cooked. You don't need to catch it, make zab, pluck its feathers, clean it, put it on the table, cook it, then eat it. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, فيخر بينك يدي مشوية. You will see a bird flying in Jannah, you will desire it, and the bird will fall in front of you already cooked. Now that we've eaten something, how about something to drink, something to wash it down? Quran says, يُسْقَوْنَ مِنْ رَحِيكٍ مَخْتُومٍ أَخْتَامُهُ مِسْكٍ That they will be given a pure wine. who seal his mouth. And you can drink as much as you please. Pints and pints. Drink it. لا فيها غول ولا هم أنها ينزفون. As you're not going to get drunk. That's the beauty of the wine of Jannah. And nor will you get a headache afterwards. There are no after effects. So drink as much as you please. Now that we've had a bite to eat, something to drink. How do we get rid of the waste? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, asked the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the same question. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, يُشَاءٌ وَرَشْحٌ كَرَشْحِ الْمِسْكِ. So a birth and sweat, which will have the fragrance of musk. Now that we've had a bite to eat, something to drink, we're going to go visit a friend. From the king in his own kingdom, of course. It's pretty far. Now we've got a choice, we've spoiled for choice. I mean, we can take a BMW down, or we can even take a Concorde, Ferrari, Lotus, no problem, it's Jannah. How about a horse which flies faster than lightning and made out of rubies? A Sahabi came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasul, he loved horses. He asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, هل في الجنة خيل؟ يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم tell me, are there any horses in Jannah? Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم replied, إن أدخلك الله الجنة فلا تشاء أن تركب على فرس من ياقوتة حمراء تطير بك حيث شئت إلا ركبت. If Allah gives you Jannah, O my companion, you will not wish to ride on a horse made out of rubies which will fly and take you wherever you please, but you will be given. Now another Sahabi radiallahu ta'ala anhum, who was also present, when he heard that he has got what he's asked for, that this will light camels. Ya Rasulullah, هل في الجنة إبل؟ Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell me, are there any camels in Jannah? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't say yes, there are camels in Jannah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, if Allah gives you Jannah, وَلَكُمْ فِيهَ مَا تَشْتَهِي وَلَكُمْ فِيهَ مَا تَدَّوِي, whatever you desire, you will be given. Whatever you ask, you will be given. And that is the general rule of Jannah. Get there first. And once you've got there, then you can have what you ask. You can get what you desire. And the biggest ni'mah that you and I, inshaAllah, we will receive in Jannah is that we will be able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will be able to see our Khaliq, our Creator. In a very long hadith narrated by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, narrated by Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in which as a Jibra'il came to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he informed the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of many things. In this hadith, one of the things that he informed the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was that he said that in Jannah we call Jumu'ah Yawm al-Mazid. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, وَبِمَا ذَاكَ, what happens in Yawm al-Mazid? What is so special about this day in Jannah? Hazrat Jibra'il replied, إِنَّ رَبَّكَ اتَّخَذَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَادِيًا فِيهِ قُسْبَانٌ مِّن مُسْكٍ أَبْيَضٍ. That Allah has made a special place in Jannah, a special wadi in Jannah, which has mounts of white musk. فَإِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ هَبَطَ مِّنْ عِلِّيِّينَ أَلَى كُرْسِيٍّ. When it is a Friday, Allah descends from the Illiyin to his chair. فَيُحُفَّ الْقُرْسِ بِقُرَاسٍ مِّن نُورٍ. Thereafter, chairs made out of nur are placed and encircle the chair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيَجِيءُ النَّبِيُّونَ حَتَّى يَجْلِسُوا عَلَى تِلْكَ الْقُرَاسِ. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala come and they sit on these chairs. Thereafter, ثُمَّ يُحَفَّ الْقُرَاسِ بِمَنَابِرٍ مِّن نُورٍ ومن ذهب مكللة بالجواهر. members made out of nur and gold and decorated with jewels are placed thereafter. And the siddiqeen and the shuhada, the masses come and they sit on these members. Thereafter, ينزل أهل الغرف من غرفهم حتى يجلسوا على تلك الكثبان. The remaining believers come and sit on these mounds of white mud. ثم يتجلى لهم عز وجل. Then Allah appears before them and Allah reveals Himself to the believers. And Allah will say, أنا الذي صدقتكم وعدي وأتممت عليكم نعمتي وهذا محل كرامتي فسلوا. But I have fulfilled my promise and I have given you Jannah and I have given you my ni'mas and blessings. This is a special place, a special place of my karam. Ask for what you please and the believers will ask and Allah will keep on fulfilling their desires. Once Allah has fulfilled their desires, فَيَخْتَ لَهُمْ فِي ذَلِكَ مَا لَا أَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى كَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. Allah will give them at that time which no eye has seen, which no ear has heard, and which has not crossed the human mind. This is why فَلَيْسُ إِلَى شَيْءٍ بِأَحْوَجْ مِنْهُمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ. There will be nothing more precious to the believers than the seeing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why they will look forward for a Friday, as they know they will be able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within this time gap, and they will receive special ni'mah on this day, this time, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is Jannah. And these are some of the ni'mah that inshallah you and I are going to receive in Jannah. We know that Jannah is our destination. The question is, how do we get to our destination? How do we get to Jannah? And this question is more important for us at this moment in time than Jannah and everything within Jannah. However, I came prepared to answer this one question. But unfortunately, I have already taken 1.5 hours of your time. And I hope the next speaker that comes, he answers this question, as it is more important than Jannah and everything within Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first of all, give me the tawfiq to amal on what I've said. Give my family the tawfiq to amal on what I've said. And Allah give you the tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillah.